The design idea was to optimize the use of limited space by overlapping functional spaces. The design was inspired by the calm and peaceful vibe of Japanese ryokan or hot spring inn. We wanted to use Japanese shoji dolls to give the space a softer look and also allow for flexibility. In doing so, we were able to create two multifunctional areas that expand the living area from 7 to 17 square meters. My name is May. I am a freelance interior and graphic designer based in Bangkok, Thailand. The owner of this project is my brother. He lives here with his wife. The building is located near Lat Phao intersection. This area is considered to be the new CBD of Bangkok. We wanted to make a space to allow the owners and visitors to escape the city chaos. When we first found the apartment, it was a brand new unit with furnished kitchen and bathroom. There was also a set of three panel sliding doors, which divided living area and bedroom. We removed the sliding doors between the living room and bedroom to completely open up the space and bring more natural light into the room. We added a platform in the bedroom and redesigned the bathroom. When opening the entrance door, on the left side is a floating cabinet with coffee corner and shoe pocket beneath. On the right side opposite the cabinet is the study corner. The floating shelves with LED lights are provided above the desk. The walls in the living area are coated with a synthetic resin that gives them a natural mortar texture. There is a big three-seater modular sofa in the center of the room. It can be separated when closing the sliding panels. We selected Samsung the frame TV that matches the wood in the rest of the apartment. It can be turned into a piece of art when the TV is turned off. I also designed a small but effective floating TV unit. The coffee table can be raised and transformed into a dining table. The kitchen is behind the TV wall. Due to the strict budget, we have not done anything with the original kitchen. It consists of sink, lens hood, induction hob, microwave niche, and hanging open cabinets. The water purifier with a tap were installed when my brother has already moved in. At the end of the room, there is a wooden box-like platform with four tatami mats. This platform can be used as a second living area or even a study. We based this design on Japanese ryokan, where the room can transform into different modes throughout the day. During the day, it is a relaxing tea room. At night, it can be turned into a sleeping area by taking out the futon mattress from the closet. The sleeping area can be closed off using the sliding panels to give more privacy and to keep the cool air in the room. The platform is high enough to make hidden storage under for my brother's board game and pillows. The washing machine and laundry area is on the balcony outside. My sister-in-law also plants roses in this area to bring a little bit of nature into the apartment. These sliding panels have another function as closet doors to cover up the mess inside when having visitors. When the room is closed from inside, the dressing area with a walk-in closet will appear. We put lights in the closets as this area lacks natural light. The bathroom walls and floor were paved with ceramic tiles in dark gray stone pattern. The floating vanity was made from the same materials that we used to make all wood furniture in the room. The LED lights were installed at the top and the bottom of this cabinet to create an atmosphere of relaxation and restfulness. I think living in a small space makes life simpler and supports sustainable lifestyle. You will buy and keep only what you really need. It also helps to reduce carbon footprint as well as saving on electricity bills.
Say hello to our new Never Too Small Essential Guide to Your Living Room, an easy-to-follow guide to design and improve your current small living space. This guide contains all you need to transform your small living room into a space you will love to spend time in. And the best part? You don't have to spend a fortune to make your space look amazing. The Never Too Small Essential Guide to Designing Your Living Room is the first in our Essential Guide series. Download your guide and start creating your very own Never Too Small inspired living room today.
Thanks for watching. If you're an architect or designer with a project we could feature, please share it with us at nevertoosmall.com/submissions.